In this episode of our van conversion series, we are modifying the bike slide in the garage of our camper van. We are storing our motorbikes inside our camper van using the bike slide. It can be extracted about 70% to easily load and unload the bikes. This bike slide is actually a defining design feature of our van. It determined the type of van we bought and it affected the majority of the design choices of the interior. It determined the height of our bed and where we put the dividing wall between the garage and the living area. We designed the bike slide to hold 3 bikes. However, I measured the bike slide to hold bikes with 26-inch wheels. Which is nice until you buy another bike that has 27.5-inch wheel size. After my heart attack and a year-long knee injury, I decided it was time to buy an e-bike. With the 27.5-inch wheels, it didn't fit the bike slide, so we have to modify the slide. To be able to fit 3 motorbikes in the slide, we also have to remove the cabinet on the side of our daughter's bed. We used to take a regular bike and 2 mountain bikes. The regular bike has bars that just fit along the cabinet. However, the handlebars of a mountain bike don't, so the cabinet had to go. To fit my new e-bike, I needed another handmade bike hitch for a through axle. Another Delta bike hitch with a 9mm quick release had to be removed. I made another do-it-yourself bike hitch using a leftover piece of wood and an electrical tube that fits the through axle exactly. Again, like the one I made before, I glued the tube in place before securing it with 3 clamps and I spray painted it in a dark gray color. This type of do-it-yourself bike hitch proved itself. I've been using the one I made earlier for about 2 years now and it has never failed me. To make the bigger bike and bigger wheels fit the bike slide, I need to extend the slide using a wooden batten placed on the edge of the bike slide. On top of this batten, I will secure the new do-it-yourself bike hitch. This just fits in the garage when the doors are closed, so there is just about enough room to fit a bigger bike in the van without a huge modification to our interior, which is nice. First, I need to remove the cork along the existing seams to get the batten to fit neatly into the bike slide. Also, to get both my old and new bike to fit the bike slide, I had to slightly move the older do-it-yourself bike hitch I made earlier a bit to the side and make sure the handlebar could just fit along the edge. I used normal screws put in from the underside of the bike slide to secure the batten to the slide. Now with the batten in place, it came to precisely placing the new bike hitch so the front end and the handlebars of the 2 bikes facing forward to just fit next to each other. This meant quite a few test fittings to get the exact position figured out. Then finally I can secure the new bike hitch to the batten on the bike slide. 4 screws will do just fine. No cork or glue was used because I want to be always able to modify the setup for the bikes. So the bike hitches need to be able to be moved or removed easily. And even before I was able to finish this video, the modification failed. A few months after modifying the slide, the wooden beam broke while I was unloading my e-bike. So I have to modify the slide again. This time I am not using a wooden beam, but a leftover piece of plywood. I am using the jigsaw to cut a shape that is rounded at the right side. Here the distance between the slide and the door is the shortest. I again secure the plywood from the underside with screws. This time I also added a metal bracket to keep the plywood in place and give it more strength. This would be much stronger and should last much longer. We will see. So that's it for this short video about our bike slide modification. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give us a like and subscribe to our channel. There's much more to come. Thanks for watching. Until the next video.